In this example, we're given the total protein concentration in solution. It's 10 micromolar. And the question we ask is, what fraction of this protein is unfolded at 25 degrees C, where we're given the delta G of unfolding, and this value then, of course, is at 25 degrees C. So what we're looking at is there's a folded version of the protein, and then it's in equilibrium with an unfolded version. And the question really is what fraction or what's the concentration that's unfolded. So we'll use the notation where N represents the concentration of folded and U represents the concentration of unfolded. And the problem says that the sum of the two types is a concentration of 10 micromolar to 10 to minus 6 molar concentration. So this is the equilibrium process. We're given delta G, which means we can calculate the equilibrium constant. And then we're going to say the equilibrium constant is equal to the concentration of the unfolded, the product over the folded. And we can use concentrations here. These are low concentrations, so treating this as ideal. Equilibrium constant is equal to the Gibbs free energy change divided by gas constant and the temperature. So we can calculate the equilibrium constant because we're given delta G, minus sign, this is 41,000 joules per mole. The gas constant, 8.314 joules per mole per Kelvin. This temperature must be absolute temperature, 273 plus 25, so 298 Kelvin. This is equal to then E to the minus 16.55. So if we do that exponential, we get a very small equilibrium constant. Not surprising, we have a positive delta G that's significant in size. And so then our equilibrium calculation is just that U over N is 6.5 times 10 to the minus 8. Essentially, we can stop here. Essentially, what this says is that essentially there's no unfolded protein. It's such a small fraction of the total. If we wanted to calculate the concentration, then since N is pretty close to 10 to the minus 6 molar, then U is equal to 10 to the minus 6 times 6.5 times 10 to the minus 8. So our concentration, 6.5 times 10 to the minus 14 molar. This is the concentration of the unfolded protein. And so this really is insignificant, and we conclude for these conditions, this temperature, all the protein is folded.